like for our friends in New Britain, in Poland over on 84 from Farmington down into Plainville, steady, but manageable rain. A little more on 84 in Hartford and Manchester and Burning Rock. So take a look at the pictures in the review last hour too. See what's kind of just now. There's more coming later on today. Now 69 cloudy down in Hartford, 71 in New England, cloudy in New England on the way up to the 70s. That's it. We have better weather. We also have some more trouble to talk about in the short and medium forecast. We'll talk about that all coming up in just a few minutes. 7:31. Let's go to the road. Good morning, Rachel Biscadelli.
Hey, good morning, Matt. So our interface is looking pretty good this morning, other than one area.
Oh, now you want to give up, dumbass. Fucking teammates that I have. No, we're losing 0-4. No, I guess they're waiting for some magical comeback. That never happens. Oh, yeah, whatever. Sure. Sure, okay. Whatever, it didn't even move 2 inches. Okay, whatever. The game was sucking their balls. Of course they won. The game sucks everybody's balls. That's all it does.
Visit ctimpactawards.org to submit your nomination before August 25th.
Wow, thanks, Matt. Start game breaking lag.
Climate change problem. And that was Amy Chalmers reporting.
Well, there goes my teammate. Because, of course, it's my teammate that leaves. It's always my teammates that leave. Okay, whatever. There goes another teammate. Well, I mean, I don't blame him. The game is sucking your balls. They lost anyway, so.
Miss the hustle. Live at the Hartford Police Department with all the details. Look in line.
Our investigators are investigating.
Details on a deadly shooting on I-84 last Friday. We now know the name of the man who was killed. Officials said Zoltan Tarek said West Haven died at a hospital. Police said they are still looking for other suspects who were involved. We know the shooting started Friday afternoon out of the side of a nightclub on 3rd Avenue and then continued onto a highway. One of those cars crashed on I-84 East, which is the video you're looking at here. Again, officials are still investigating that shooting.
Police are looking for whoever vandalized a picnic area in Sprague with a car. Check out this video from the
what? Fucking whatever. Had a 2-goal lead. Oh, that was a wrong thing to do. So the game sucked their balls and I lost. How expected. All I'm ever allowed to do is lose. Anything and everything, so I lose. Leads are fake, wins are fake. The only thing that's real is losses.
Right, if you're looking for the toothpaste thing, it's
Thank you.
police said when they went to arrest him, they told him he was going to fight and that he would shoot any officer who came near him. And more granted, that did not happen. It's important to know. But for more details on Hernandez's criminal charges, you can go to Fox 61.com.
Still Edgar, Fox 61 this morning.
An annual back to school celebration kicks off today. Fox 61's Keith McGillivray is going to bring you to the XL Center.
Not even an assist.
We decided to partner with the Connecticut Humane Society to support our community and improve the lives of every potential that we can.
At a crossbar. Wow. As if I didn't hit that a million times. Oh, wait, I have.
Writers Guild of America contracts that are also produced in the U.S. Right now, the WGA is also
Down along, let's see, down here around, we set 32 Bakersfield again, and in Brownside Rose, Rose Road, let's go then. If you please correct me if you did that, I'm not saying it right. A big storm out to sea now. The Cape still seeing some moderate activity. We've been great, but the storm itself is still well off towards the west, and there's a trailing cold front that will approach later on. Needs more significant, stronger, severe weather down towards the south today, but we are under a level one, a marginal risk of storms. But I think if you're watching it from the Orange County, maybe even Middlesex County, keep an eye to the sky later on. Everyone's got a shot at seeing some storm in this, but it's close enough, and I'll move from that so that you can see parts of Long Island really going to get drilled again later on today. And you can see Chantibbins is a few miles away, according to the guidance. That's a little too close for comfort, so we'll watch that later on. We'll get that out of the way.
Crossbar, because of course.
significant, and then we will drive things out for the later part of the Wednesday and the Thursday. Temperature's getting into the low 70s today. That's it. With the cloud and humidity still there, as I showed you. Tomorrow we get to the upper 70s, lower 80s, and we look for a little more in the way of sunshine. And we'll continue that sunnier trend as we go into Thursday. By Friday, chances of storms up there. But the weekend right now, looking great because there's a lack of humidity. Behind this one, we finally get some of that drier air from the North Brooklyn, and that may provide them a fantastic weekend. All we have to do is get there. 8:21 on a certified Tuesday. Back to you.
Thank you. Well, as you're planning your next holiday vacation, you're always